The Okavango River Delta has seen a tremendous surge in tourist arrivals since the end of the UNITA banditry threat in 2002. The operators believe cultural museums, villages, and group cultural performances present an opportunity for locals to participate in the sector. Nunda Lodge co-owner Cameron Wilson says the few cultural nights that his lodge had organized in the past proved to be popular with the visitors. Wilson noted that the lodge plans to introduce game walks to its package, where the Sun will take tourists on trekking expeditions.
The initiative has been started with the Barakwena people on the other side. I think there's a lot of scope for local people to be involved in tourism, and in particular with cultural things. For example, having a cultural village, because a lot of people come here and they want to experience what the African culture is, or the Hambukusho culture, or the Barakwena, which are the Bushmen on the other side. They want to experience how these people live, how they work, how do they survive. So that is it's a big plus point. And then the other is that there are no attractions, there are no attractions, but it is starting. There is an initiative coming about by the Barakwena to do walks, game walks, where you actually go with a bushman and he will take you into the buffalo park and he will walk with you and show the people the tracks, show the people the scat, show the people the trees and what it's used for. That is so undeveloped, and there's such a big need for that, because a lot of people have seen elephant. Once they've seen a few hundred elephant, they don't want to see another elephant. They want to experience something else, and that's vital.
He said before such an initiative is entertained, identified individuals will be trained to revive and hone their trekking skills. Ngepi Camp owner Mark Adikok runs a plant a tree project where residents earn an income per tree they look after.
The environment's being depleted by people chopping down trees, and which then affects the habitat for the birds, because they're cutting away, it's a reduction of habitat, okay? And less habitat, less birds, which in fact is fighting tourism. That's against what we're trying to do. So what Ngepi does is we plant, 2 years ago we planted 4,000 seedlings in 1 year. And what we do is we give them to the community, whoever wants, and whoever, an individual, and they take them and plant them around their house or in their field, wherever they want to plant them. And we go every month and we've got a GPS with a camera on it, and we photograph the person with the tree. So each tree has a GPS coordinate, and the person who is looking after that tree, they get paid $10 per month per tree.
Adikok said plantlets are usually provided to the willing individuals with an attempt to replace the trees cut down for firewood. At the moment, locals only benefit through employment, roadside marketing of craftswork, and selling of firewood to lodge owners.